Okay, so at this point I have all my pieces cut out. I have all my holes punched, which took forever and ever. So at this point, I am going to add the fur lining. So I ran into some problems because regular adhesive does not work well with this shearling, this lambskin or lamb fur. So I called the tanner where I got this, and what they had said was that the tip I got was use the spray adhesive, which thank goodness I have home, because you know it's Friday, traffic is a nightmare. Now it's that time of the day where traffic is a nightmare, and I really don't want to have to travel. And this is the left, and this is the left. Do the right. All right, and I'm looking to see where my fur is. See over here, I'm missing fur here, so I'm gonna go where it's nice and thick. Just want to darken up my other lines. And what I'm using is a gel pen, because you can wipe it off of leather if you don't let it sit too long and dry, because it's an oil based. So, with a little bit of pressure, you should be able to wipe it off. And if not, just use a little bit of alcohol with it. You'll be able to get it off. Alcohol takes most things off. Adhesives, paint, dyes. You can lift dyes sometimes. I'm going in the middle of this fur because this is the nicest part, and on your footbed you want the nicest part. You want the thickest, most dense fur. So that's what we're doing. But you want consistency, even consistency with the density too. So this part of the skin has the most consistent density. You know, I don't want to waste. You know, and the thing is, I mean, I using furs is real fur is really controversial, but I see that sheep is. Part of the is a, you know, sheepskin is a or lambskin is a byproduct of the meat industry, so I don't have issue with it, but I still treat it very respectfully because it was a living creature, and you know, we want to make it proud of what it's going to be. And I have one more piece over here. into the whole hide. This is a nice piece right here for the toe. Is that gonna fit? Or are we gonna be too thin? Oh, we're too thin. Not wide enough. I'm gonna go over here, because we don't want it too furry and too thick. No, there's good consistency there. Actually, let's go over here. So that's a nice natural fit right here. Let's go here. It said we want it where it's not too hot. We want the thicker part of the fur more towards the ankle. So this is the top of the moccasin over here, so we're gonna go ahead and trace this. Now with fur, you never want to cut it with a scissor. It's just a major no-no. Okay, and this is the right. I always put the client's initials on the leather too, if I'm cutting more than on the pieces that I've cut out, besides left and right. If I'm working on more than one order. So here we go. Trace around. Okay. Alright, now I'm going to get a razor. We're going to start over here. So I don't know if you can see my lines. So I'm going very gently. I'm just scoring the skin and then going a little bit deeper. You need to use a fresh new knife with every project or blade on your X-Acto knife. You can see I'm getting a nice cut. Follow your lines. Right, so if we were to take a scissor to this, our ends would be really messed up and crushed down and uneven, and it would just really look bad. So we don't want to do that. Just take a razor. So this skin I got from a tanner. Up in Maine. So this lamb was raised in Maine and tanned in Maine. And what we're gonna do then, you know, what looks like waste is not waste, because what I do is I find other projects for the small pieces. Going around curves is a little bit tricky, but we just go nice and slow. You want a good cut. You're not chewing on yourself, are you, Helga? Well, you were chewing on yourself. Don't chew. So take your time, don't rush. So when you rush, that's when you make mistakes, and make sure that you're not tired when you're doing this part. Because if you make mistake. There's no fixing it. That's it. You gotta cut a new piece, and you don't want to waste a hide. I think it's disrespectful to a hide. I'm not going all the way down, I'm just till I can feel it almost going all the way through. Some parts have gone through, but most haven't. And you don't want to just pull any pieces, you want to make sure that they're cut through. So here's our vamp that we have for the bottom of the moccasin. I'll go inside so it's nice and soft and warm. Got the second one. Now what I'm doing is I'm pulling the skin a little bit taut. Just ever so slightly, just pressure so it doesn't move. No, I'm not all the way through on my cut, but that's okay. Just want to get the initial cut nice and clean. Back. And this is where you need a little bit of pressure. So it's best if you leave. Don't do a rough cut and then think that you're going to go in and clean cut easily after. So it's better to leave it on the hide and do a clean cut the first cut. A lot less waste. Quicker, cleaner cut. I tell you, this skin is tanned just so beautifully. I mean, for myself, I would just, I'd love a pair of moccasins like this. Or muckalucks or boots. Even a pair of gloves would be nice and warm, mittens. This is so buttery soft. Oh, it feels so nice. I like working with it a lot. This is my first time, and I really like it. A lot. You know, here's the second. That came out beautiful. And then we just have the toe piece. So again, I'm pulling a little bit taut, you can see. Sorry for my hand being in the way. I'll be out of your way in a minute. Ow. That was not smart. like cutting yourself. Now the reason why I'm not going all the way to the end of the skin is that they used to glaze the back of the hide is on the fur that's sticking out. So that part isn't exactly the nicest, but that's okay. Because no one's gonna see. So I've cut away from that. No, I don't like how it feels either. See, and by doing it this way, we're not cutting any of the fur fibers. We're just cutting through the skin, so you'll be able to pull it out and you'll have minimal loss of fur. Right?